Greetings to you all and welcome to this webinar. My name is Edward van Leent. I will be your Master of Ceremonies. Today we're going to talk about the uptime tier certification upgrading to NCTIA 942 certification. So what we're going to do today is talk about a couple of items. First, a little introduction about EPI, who we are, for those of you who might not be familiar with us yet. We're going to address a little bit the history of the TIA 942 standard. Then we'll do a bit of presentation around the differences between uptime versus TIA 942. And then we go into some of the details of the TIA 942 upgrade program. And I thought it would be very good to discuss a little bit about the misperceptions and confusions that are in the market. Of which, unfortunately, there are many coming from different sources. So I thought it might be a good idea to address some of those fundamental things like can TIA be certified, etc., etc. We'll address also a little bit if you want to learn more about the standard itself, and then we do some conclusions and Q&A. It is estimated that all in all, this webinar will run for about 45 to 60 minutes. Hopefully it will run about 45 minutes, so we have some time to also do some Q&A through the chat screen, which you can find on the screen in front of you. So let's have a look at EPI. We are a company that started in 1987 in the UK, so we are basically a 30-plus-year-old company now, and we moved our headquarters to Singapore in 1999. We have a number of offices around the world, about 9 of them, serving different continents, and we work primarily through a large partner network. So we have a reach in about 60 countries in over 120 cities. In terms of what we do, EPI is very focused on the data center industry. We have three distinct services that we deliver to this market: design, evaluation, and validation. This is a service that we provide to customers who are embarking on a data center design and build project and would like to ensure that before they start the actual construction and fit out, that the design is meeting the standard of choice. Very important, we, of course, some small mistakes that might have been made or overlooked during the design process could have, of course, a large business impact if you try to resolve it later on. The other service that we do is auditing and certification, which we do for the physical facilities as well as for the data center governance, operations, and maintenance processes. And we are also providing professional data center training, addressing governance, addressing operations, as well as design and build. We are pretty well known in the industry, I would say, so hopefully a lot of you will recognize us. We have been awarded a variety of awards. We have been part of a variety of publications as well and are working closely with a number of data center event providers. And as a result, we have had, you know, and still have many customers, big, small, very complex, less complex, very critical, and maybe less critical, etc. So obviously, if we can help them, I hope we can help you as well. So that is about EPI. Very short introduction. Let's have a look at the history of the TIA 942 standard. It all started in the mid of 2001 when there was a working group committee put together to address the telecoms infrastructure for the data center. And that working group got together, started working on requirements for structured cabling, etc. And as part of that, they also included other aspects related to the data center, electrical, mechanical, and various other aspects, which we will address a bit later. A lot of work went into it, as a result that in 2005, the first edition of the TIA 942 was published. And after that, It has undergone a variety of updates till the last version, which came out last year in July, which is called NCTIA 942-B. So if you would like to learn more about this particular standard, then this is the version that you should be looking at. Be very careful. Unfortunately, in various projects, we come in contact with customers that say, I have a copy of the TIA in front of me, and it is an outdated version. Yeah, so make sure you always have the latest version when you are reviewing your data center or building it according to this particular standard. So let's have a look at the two main players in this market and what this program or this webinar is about, uptime versus TIA 942. I would like to address it at a few domain areas, so to speak. The first one, the actual organizations. I think it's good to compare them. Uptime as well as TIA are originating out of the US. The uptime started in 1993 and TIA in 1988, so 1 year later after EPI was established in 1987. The type of organization, Uptime is a traditional commercial organization where TIA, the association, is incorporated as a non-profit organization. Accredited standards development organization, I think this is very important because obviously everybody who claims to develop a standard should hopefully be in what they call SDO, a standards development organization. Unfortunately, Uptime is not in that particular category. TI is an official SDO. And accreditation, because when you are a development organization, you need to have accreditation so that there is a clear process in place that is vetted to see whether you do the right thing when you establish a standard. Obviously, because Uptime is not an SDO, it doesn't apply to them. For TIA, they have opted for ENSI. So be aware that ENSI is the accreditation organization. So they are basically establishing the process and review the process for developing and maintaining standards. So ENSI is not involved in the actual content writing, so to speak, the technical content. So they only oversee the process. So TIA and the working group are the ones that are providing and writing the technical content. In terms of the document itself, the latest publication dates, Uptime has released in January of this year a new version of their tier topology document. So 2018, as I said before, TIA came out in July 2017 with their latest version. In terms of chain cycle, Uptime doesn't really have a strict update cycle, so to speak. It is based on market feedback, etc. Whereas TIA does it typically within a 3 to 5 year time frame, which is the description as per ENSI requirements. It doesn't really matter, of course, updates, because even when you do an update, say in 3 years, it could actually mean that you are reviewing whether the document is still relevant, and you might then make changes or even decide that the standard is still perfectly okay and just maintain it as is. Document size, 12 pages, so pretty slim for the Uptime document, 134 pages for TIA. Just to make it clear, this includes everything, the front page and the back page and everything in between. Uptime is a bit short document, and that is related to that they are not very detailed in all the audit criteria, as we say, because they describe more the outcome that is desired for the various levels of data centers, which we'll address later. TIA has also that description. So if, for example, you're looking at a tier 3 or rated 3 data center, then Uptime says that the outcome expectation is a concurrent maintainable data center. That description you will find in the TIA 942 document as well. So that is the overarching requirement. But TIA has chosen to be more prescriptive and lay down some suggestions in terms of how you can achieve that. Audit criteria, As I said, for uptime partial description, because it's more outcome based, so they don't go into a high level of detail, so to speak, in the nuts and bolts that you require, whereas in the TAA document, it's much more clear. So for designers who really like to understand all the requirements, then the TAA document lists and spell them out so you can actually verify them for yourself very, very easily. Conformity levels, tier 1, 2, 3, 4, well known in the industry, defined by Uptime Institute. TAA was using that as well, but now that has changed into rated or rating. Although I must say that still many data centers are using the term tier 1, 2, 3, 4 also for a data center that is actually designed and built as per the TAA 942 standard. Whether that is possible or not, stick around and I will address that later in the confusions and misperception chapter. Outcome-based, well, as I said, both are outcome-based. Guideline or standard, this is always a bit of a contentious point, I must say. Of course, the term standard, as we define it, is when it is issued by an SDO. And as I said, uptime is not an SDO. Although some people say you can state also that something is maybe a de facto standard. Now, in an auditing type of sense, when we're talking about standards according to the ISO principles, we're talking about a document that is transparent, that has all the audit criteria available, which auditors can validate, etc., etc. Adoption, well, both TAA and Uptime, well known throughout the industry in various continents, so both have presence in a variety of data centers and continents. In terms of the scope, I think this is a very important one. In the tier topology of the Uptime document, basically we are only addressing the electrical and mechanical. In the new version in 2018, there is a very, very small description on telecom, not more than you know, two entry paths at the clear separation, but that's about it. For the rest, no other things are like the building safety, fire safety, etc., etc. TAA is in that sense a true complete data center standard, which doesn't only address the electrical and mechanical system, which are, of course are very important, but so is telecommunication. Because frankly speaking, without telecommunication, there is just no data center. You can imagine that your data center is running perfectly okay, but your branch office, which is connected to a telecoms network, need to be ensured of connectivity. Otherwise, it serves no purpose to have the data center running. So in that sense, we see more and more people saying this is actually very, very complete, and they appreciate it. In terms of the audits, both Uptime and TAA, you know, we find data centers around the globe which are certified. In terms of the choice of auditors, for Uptime, they have reserved the right that Uptime consultants are doing the audits for those organizations that would like to follow Uptime tier topology. TAA has a different approach. Various organizations can actually audit. Bad or not bad, I don't know. I think as an organization, you typically would like to have some choice, even if it's only not because for commercial purposes, but sometimes, you know, working relationships are not always smooth and you would like sometimes have a different choice. Certification body, I think this is very critical. The Uptime Institute is basically a commercial organization and is not registered as a certification body. TAA, those organizations that are actually executing audits for TAA 942 conformity, you have to check that because unfortunately there are some organizations that are not a certification body claiming to be able to do certification, which of course if you look at ISO and NC auditing principles is a big no-no. Unfortunately, there's not a very strong regulation at this point in time in place, so be careful, otherwise your investment in auditing might go to waste. The audit process, Uptime has defined their own process. It is not very clear what it is based on. We believe that it's based on best practices. For the TAA auditing, anybody who is a certification body will follow the strict ISO procedures. Costing-wise, it's well known that Uptime is a pretty heavy investment for data centers. undergo a theatropology certification, where the TAA orders tend to be a little bit more on the wallet, so to speak. One of the reasons we'll discuss later again when we talk about some confusions. Very important, both for TAA as well as Uptime, there are actually two types of certifications. One is what we call the design certification, which is, as it says, to evaluate the design, and typically this is done hopefully before construction. Unfortunately, we have seen some data centers that, although they were constructed, still opted to only go for the design certificate. And it could have many, many reasons. One of them might be commercial. The other part might be that the data center is actually not meeting the design, and I'll come to that a bit later. Uptime is awarding a 2-year certificate. So from the start of your design, so to speak, till implementation, you get 2 years, and after that it expires, and by right you should move to facility certification. For TAA, it's defined as 1 year, although extensions are possible. So if you are still in your design phase, or if you are still in the construction mode, then it is possible with evidence to extend it for another year. Facility certificate lifecycle, this is an interesting one. Theoretically, for Uptime, it's a one-time thing that you do, and after that, it's okay. So you get a certificate for life. Although there must be a proper note there that Uptime expects that customers who make a facility change, yeah, do report it to them, so that Uptime can go back and review again whether the change that the customer has made might have an impact on the certificate, i.e. Do the customer still, you know, meet the requirements of, for example, the statement concurrent maintainability or fault tolerant. For the TAA, it works very different. This is based, again, on the ISO auditing principles, which is based on that you get a certificate after you have completed, of course, the audit and satisfactory got rid of all the potential non-compliances. The next year, you get a surveillance audit. The following year, you get another surveillance audit. And after that, you get a recertification audit. So this is basically the traditional ISO-based auditing cycle, and I think personally that this makes more sense, because I am not so sure how many data centers are actually recertifying or basically reporting all the changes that they have made. I know from experience that some data centers do not want to replicate, so to speak, because they are worried that if they report a change, it's going to be very costly to do the re-auditing again. And potentially maybe even some non-conformities might be detected, and then they would have to, you know, correct them. We believe that is not the right approach. That's why we have opted for the ISO cycle of auditing, because that is the only way to make sure that a certificate that is on the wall of a customer is truly reflecting what they have. So let's have a look at the Uptime to TAA upgrade program. Why did we actually come up with this particular program? I think there are a few reasons that we have established when talking to customers. When we talk to them about Uptime versus TAA, etc. I think first of all, a lot of the customers, and when I say customers, it could be the data center operator owner themselves, but also their end user, they more and more come to the knowledge and conclusion and knowing that the TAA topology is predominantly looking at the electrical and mechanical system. And because of that, it doesn't address the full scope of a data center, people start realizing that there is still some residual risk, so to speak. So if you don't do a proper audit on your physical security or fire safety, etc., then you can have all the redundant power and cooling in the world, but you are still leaving yourself and your customer at great risk. I think also credibility issues. I know that some customers went to, for example, a hosting site or the organized by a telecom provider, and the telecom provider said, we are certified for basically power and cooling only based on Uptime. I think a lot of customers do not really believe that that is a great match. If you are a telecom provider and you are not even doing an audit on your own telecoms infrastructure, that does not sound very good, I think, in general. Another big risk, design certificates not matching implementation. It is an unfortunate thing that is happening in the industry, that some data centers go for a design certificate of Aptam Institute and never move beyond that one. So now they proudly display a design certificate, might or might not have implemented the data center, the physical data center, based on that design, and therefore kind of like misleading themselves and, of course, the end user. And that could be, I think, very, very tricky. You can imagine if I'm a customer and I trust your design certificate, but in fact you have built something else, and therefore my IT environment has to go down one day or another, then I probably will call my lawyer because you have obviously been misleading me. This is not really something you can blame Aptam for. This is really up to the customer that should say once the design certificate is expiring, they need to take a next step to make sure and prove that the facility is in good shape as well. But I think a lot of people realize that, you know, that is what they need to do. But yeah, to go for the full-blown tier topology constructed facility certification, yeah, could be quite costly. And I think that is also what, you know, is stopping quite a few data center operators to make that step forward, which by right should be done. So what we thought is, you know, that there are three very good reasons why existing Aptam certificate data center holders could move or should move to the TA942. First of all, a much broader scope. As I said, TA942 is truly addressing all the areas of a data center, which I think is very important for any data center operator owner to understand where the risks are. It is a true standard. As I indicated, we can argue about what is true standard, but anybody who is not an SDO, who doesn't publish a document under ISO, NC or whatever, typically can be regarded as a guideline. You might argue maybe a de facto standard, but this is very, very different. And I think also a very advantage for customers to upgrade would be the cost considerations. It is no surprise and it is no secret that especially commercial data center operators are fighting more than ever for the customer. And every dollar that you spend on either the infrastructure facility or even certification ultimately has to be earned back out of the rec. So spending $100,000, $150,000 on a certificate and that basically being earned back out of the rec could be, you know, a bit difficult, I would say. Or it could just take quite a bit of time. So what options do you have? Well, first you could look at if you have an Aptam design certificate for your data center, you can move to the TIA942 design document certificate. So basically a design certificate, yeah, moving to a design document certificate. Another option, if you have a design certificate, you move it from design certification from Aptam into the TIA942 constructed facility certification. Obviously, this is a much more cost-effective and a much broader scope type of audit. Or option three, if you have an existing constructed facility certificate, which in principle doesn't expire, you can augment that and add the TIA942 constructed facility certification to it. So be aware that this program is not aimed to displace. So if you would like to keep your existing Aptam certification, by all means, you can do so and add, for example, the TA942 certification to it to have a more robust overall certification scheme. Some customers might opt for a replacement. And again, that is a business decision that every data center operator needs to evaluate on the pros and cons. Who is eligible? Well, the eligibility for this particular program that we have put together is any data center which has an Aptam certificate, okay? It might be design, it might be a constructed facility, the certificate might be valid, or it might even be an expired certificate. Yeah, so anybody with a certificate for the Aptam Theatopology is eligible. Again, be aware that there are two parts. We have the certificate for design as well as for constructed. So depending on which one you would like to do, you can take your pick. Uptime design certificate, as I said, well, here it says 1 year. Actually, it should be 2 year. It is a 2 year validity. And as I said, the constructed facility has no end date. So who can benefit from this program? Well, I think if your data center has a design certificate, which is either expired or it is about to expire, you really have only a couple of options. First is, of course, do nothing. But that, of course, makes you lose the validity of a uptime design certificate, which is probably not a very good idea. You can move to the uptime facility certification. That is, of course, an option. But again, cost consideration and scope should be evaluated. Or what we believe might be a very good option is to move to the TA942 design document or facility certification. Again, broader scope, true standard, and definitely cost competitive, very cost competitive, I would say. Another option, if your data center has a constructed facility certificate, well, again, there are a couple of options here. You do nothing, and your cert will live on forever. But again, I've put there a note, is this really credible? As I said before, more and more customers are getting very, very smart, and they will simply not believe you when you say that your cert has been done 4, 5, 6 years ago and you never made any change. I think most customers now realize that this is not the reality of today's world, where IT is very, very heavily undergoing changes. The other option, if you have a constructed facility certificate, of course, you don't want to throw it away. You could add the TA942 design or facility certificate. Be aware that for design, obviously, that is typically the first step towards the facility certification. For those customers who would like to validate the design before they move into constructed facility, although there are also customers that take the step immediately to go straight into the facility certification if the data center is, of course, already structured. So I think with that, you get a better scope, therefore, a better quality data center, or at least a view of a better quality data center, and definitely at a very competitive price point. So I think overall, from a risk management, this could be a nice option. So how does the upgrade program really work? Well, very simple. Obviously, first we do all the paperwork as per the traditional dealings. Then we would do the review of your design. We do the physical audit of your data center. And then after that, you will get a report with non-conformities. Hopefully you can close those non-conformities, and then a certificate will be awarded and you will enter into the what we call certificate maintenance mode, i.e. the regular surveillance and recertification audits. Due to the larger scope, you can imagine for uptime topology, you probably were very focused on the electrical and mechanical systems, which again in the upgrade program to TA of course will be addressed as well. But we will, of course, also look at telecommunications, fire safety, physical security, etc., etc. But do not worry if you go for an audit. The auditor by right will give you a list of documents that you should put together so that they can do an audit which goes very, very smooth. As I said, the audit report will address all the areas, basically at a high level, related in 4 categories, telecoms, electrical, architectural, which includes fire safety, etc., physical security, and the mechanical section. So with that, you can basically review your site and see what is a need for improvement. And after that, hopefully you get your certificate, either design or the constructed facility certificate, and you will get your stamp, which obviously you can put on your business cards, websites, and so forth. So that is actually the very simple process. The good news is once you are certified, you will also be listed on the website, which is the TA-942.org, which is basically a website which is aimed at being a central repository where you can find constructed data centers and data centers with design certificate, as well as auditing companies and auditors and consultants. So I would recommend you to check this one out. So with this, I would like to address a couple of misperceptions or confusions as they float around in the market, which I think is very, very important. The first one is that they say that NCTA 942 is an American standard, and therefore it cannot be applied in other countries. Well, this is a false statement. Yes, the standard is developed in the US. However, the committee is a multinational, multilingual, a multi-country committee. And therefore, what used to be in the original document, in the one that was released in 2005, where indeed it looked very much like an American standard, including indications of voltage systems, etc., that all has been removed. So now the TIA 942-B is truly a very global standard, which talks about general principles, etc. So yes, no matter where you live, you can apply it. And as you can see probably on the 942.org website, you will see that it has been applied in various parts of the world. Another misperception or confusion is that they say TIA does not certify data centers. No, that is very, very true. And I would urge you to think about the similarity with ISO. ISO is similar to TIA, an SDO, a Standards Development Organization. And Standards Development Organization, as the words say, they only do the development of standards. The actual certification for those standards is entrusted on what we call CBs, or the certification bodies. So ISO does not do any audits as well, as you know. ISO writes the standard, and then in your country, you'll probably have a number of organizations that are actually doing the certification. So in that sense, TIA is exactly a similar structure. Another perception or confusion is that data centers cannot be certified. And typically, they tend to bridge that back to the statement that TIA is not doing certification. Again, this is a very false statement, because basically any standard, in this case the 942, can actually be certified against if you are a certification body. Okay, so again, it is important when you're dealing with people who you entrust to do an audit for you that they are a registered certification body and it's not some consultant, etc. Another confusion or a worry that often is placed upon customers. They say, be very, very careful, because if you just miss one item out of the standard, you're going to be in big, big trouble. And very often, customers are made very, very scared. Why? Because a lot of the people do not understand what a standard auditing is all about. Standard audits are based on what they call the intent of a clause. So for example, sometimes people are made scared. They say, look, the document says that the car park must be outside of your building. And you have a car park inside the building. That is a problem. You will never get your certificate for TIA. That is totally false and incorrect. Okay? What we need to look at is the intent. Now, what is the intent of having cars outside of the building? Well, there are two reasons really for it when we wrote that into the standard. The first reason, a car could spontaneously turn into fire. Short circuit in the wiring or the batteries, etc. Another risk could be that somebody doesn't like you, put explosives in the car, drive into the car park and blow the car up. Now, if you can prove to me that you have mitigated both risks, so for example, you have a boom barrier, you check the car for any potential explosives, then you have taken care of that particular risk and you are fine. Maybe the fire risk is still there, so we want to see whether you have fire detection in the car park, fire suppression, maybe you have CCTV to detect it very clearly up front as well, etc. So again, by taking care of that, you've actually mitigated the risks that normally would be already mitigated when you have a car park outside of the building. So please be very, very careful. What I normally tell to customers, don't read the document like a lawyer, okay? Because in the end, that is not how it was intended to be written. Now, that is where the help of a data center consultant or a TAA consultant or a TAA auditor can help you with evaluating your current data center against those potential, what you might consider to be a non-conformity. Another misperception or confusion, and it's a heavy one, and I know it's a heavy loaded definition. You cannot use the word tier when you are a NCTAA 942 data center. This is a very false statement. Unfortunately, this is typically claimed by Uptime, who say that they own the word tier. That is incorrect. The term tier is not protected under trademark law, because it is a general statement to indicate levels. So for example, in the telecom industry, for those familiar, telecoms infrastructures, they often define it as a tier one telecom provider, et cetera, et cetera. In other areas, people call them tier. Now, obviously, you cannot say I'm a tier three data center based on Uptime if you have not done proper certification, either design or facility from Uptime, because then, of course, you would be misleading the market and misappropriately using their name. So be very careful, you cannot do that. But if you say I'm an NCTAA 942 data center based on rated 3/tier 3 or AKA 3, as some people call it, also known as tier 3, nothing wrong with that, because unfortunately, still plenty of people, even though they built based on the TA 942, they still use loosely the term tier, because it's just a term that has been around in the industry for many, many years. In the true, perfect, theoretical world, of course, people should use the term tier when they talk about Uptime. That makes it easier to understand that it was built according to that topology. Or people should say rated or rated 3, because they've built according to NCTAA 942. But again, the fact of the matter is that people just use those words interchangeably. Again, do not worry, that is fine. Another confusion, a data center cannot be certified for Uptime and TAA at the same time. You have to make a choice. It's either left or you have to go right. Not true. Please remember that both are now based on the outcome-based statements. So if you want to be a rated 3 or tier 3, then both for Uptime as well as TA, you need to prove that you are a concurrent maintainable data center. For Uptime, of course, electrical, mechanical only. For TA, yeah, that would also include a range of other things such as telecommunications in detail. Okay, now be aware, the way that Uptime think a data center should look like versus TA, there are some technical differences. For example, in the generator section, the TAA is perfectly okay with standby generators, whereas in the Uptime tier topology, they are using the generator as the basis for audit principles to check on concurrent maintainability, which means you need to be able to prove continuous generation. So although there are some technical differences at some level of detail, those can actually be worked out for both parties. So no issue there. You can have both certificates if you wish to do so. Another thing that we would like to hear, or that we hear quite often, that people say it's much more difficult to be TAA certified compared to Uptime. Now, in my view, if something is more difficult, then typically it means there is more quality and it's more comprehensive. But I think we're a bit confused here. Okay, if you look at the same scope, so TAA versus Uptime, both looking at Uptime and TAA from an electrical and mechanical perspective only, again, both are stating concurrent maintainable or fault tolerant requirements depending on the rating tier level that you choose. In that sense, it is really not harder to get TAA or Uptime certified. I personally would like to say that Uptime is more harder, because they have some very heavy requirements in terms of environmental conditions that you need to take care into account. Like I said, generators need to be fully continuous, where TA says standby is fine, which obviously has a big price impact, etc. But SEC, looking at electrical and mechanical, both are very achievable, and one is not really overly more difficult than the other. Now, to some extent, you can argue it's true that it's a little bit more difficult, because TAA is, of course, introducing much more elements in terms of the data center overall build. So we talk about, again, the architectural aspects, fire safety, et cetera, et cetera. So yes, because it's more comprehensive, you could argue that it might be a bit more difficult. But hey, if you want to build a good quality data center, then I don't think that just looking at power and cooling is enough. Another one that I would like to address is that TA certification is cheaper, therefore it cannot be good. I think that is a bit nonsense. Obviously, as I explained before, Uptime is the only one that can do other thing. Therefore, you, if you ask for three quotes, it's basically Uptime, Uptime, and Uptime. Although it might be channeled through different artificial channels, but in the end of the day, it all comes back to the same source. Therefore, very hard to be able to get some commercial terms that might be favorable to you when doing negotiations. The TAA 9-2, again, multiple organizations are able to do certification, hence, therefore, you are able to have more capabilities to basically, you know, negotiate between the various parties and basically get hopefully a little bit better terms for you. So that's what I had a little bit on perceptions and confusions. I could go on for another hour, but you know, given the interest and time, I would like to keep it at that. If you have more questions, then of course, always let me know. If you want to learn more about the TAA 9-2, the first source is of course the document itself. Be aware, it's a copyrighted document, so please respect the copyrights. You can go to the web address indicated here, global.ihs.com. Where you can do a search for the TA 9-2 and you'll get the download link, or you can also order the paper-based copies. If you would like to learn a bit more from a overall perspective, TAA and EPI has made an agreement in 2013 for the development of a number of courses, and those courses are indicated here. Three courses. One is the CTDC, the Certified TAA Design Consultant. This is for those people who would like to understand more about what the requirements are and how that physically need to be implemented. So here we're going basically through clause by clause, so to speak, and explain what that means from a design implementation perspective. Three-day course, very intense. Once you've completed that one, you could consider to go to the CTIA, which is the Internal Auditors course. This is basically a course aimed at those people that would like to prepare their organization for a third-party external audit. So you will learn all about what the audit process is, document requirements, etc., etc., resource allocations, and so forth. And then ultimately, one could go to the CTEA, the External Auditor. This is the person that would ultimately do a full audit and validation of the design and or the physical implementation. It's the only course in the world that is for this. Obviously, EPI and TA has the agreement made up for this courses. EXIN is the accreditation body as well as the examination body. So it's completely impartial from EPI. So EXIM develops the exam criteria to make sure that you understand the right things, and they are also the accreditation body to oversee the material. Be aware that before you can enter into this particular training program, you must have some data center certification already. If you look at, say, the EPI programs, we have the CDCP, the Certified Data Center Professional. There are some other organizations that provide training in a similar space. So we have some of them approved, some are not approved, unfortunately, but this is how it works. The reason why we have this prerequisite is that in the CTDC, we are not going to tell you what an air conditioning is, what a UPS is, what the difference is between the VFI and the VI class UPS, etc. So we assume that you have some good, decent knowledge on data center equipment, etc., etc., because otherwise we would be doing a double job. Okay. In terms of the info, if you want to get some more information on the training, you can go to our website, epi-ap.com, where you can see the schedule, what is running, etc., etc. And then I would like to move into the conclusions, and we're going to open the floor for the Q&A. So we're running at very good timing, I see. So the conclusion, the NCTA 9-2 standard. Yeah, it's a standard developed by an SDO. It has a much wider scope compared to the uptime tier topology. And I think that is very, very good for any data center, whether it's enterprise or commercial, because this really helps you to reduce the risk for yourself as well as that of your customers. TA 942 certification, yes, data centers can be certified, so don't be confused anymore. It is there. The organizations that can actually do the audit, check with them whether they are a certified body, SAB, and check whether they have the appropriate credentials. And the credentials are CTDC, CTIA, and in the future, CTEA. I saw some questions coming in regarding this, which I'll answer shortly. The benefits for upgrading from TA, from uptime to TA, I think again, just to repeat, wider scope, therefore overall risk reduction for the data center operator, operator owner and the customers. TA 942 audit is far more cost effective. I think you'll see typically that a data center which normally is an uptime certification, roughly around $150,000. It would typically be in the range of $20,000, $30,000, maybe $40,000. So there's a real great cost savings. And for those customers who have a valid certificate or an invalid, I would say, because you have both options of uptime, we have some additional level of discount. So you could even, with a very cost-effective measure, either get two certificates or move from one to another. Okay, and I think the certification issued by certification bodies instead of a commercial organization that is not a certification body will give much more trust, especially to those customers who are very much aware about how certification works, those that are typically undergoing the ISO certification. If you would like to have more information, if you would like to hear more about how you could upgrade from uptime to TA942, please write an email to the address here, sales@epi-certification.com. If you are interested in the TA training programs, then you can write at sales@epi-ap.com. And with that, I would like to go to the questions and answers. I saw already a couple of questions coming in here. The first one is the question that says, is the ATD from uptime approved? Yes, it is. So the ATD course is approved as a prerequisite for entering into the CTDC. Yeah, so that one is approved. So anybody with ATD, in fact, also ATS, which is the accredited tier specialist from uptime, both are approved to enter into the CTDC track. Another question. What about the CTEA course? Yeah, that is one that has been hanging a bit, to be honest. It is expected to be in either end of this year, but most likely because of accreditation rules in the beginning of next year. And the reason why this has been delayed, because it has been on our list already for a while, is simple that we need to have a decent install base for CTIA in various countries to make the CTEA worth. We need typically about 8 to 10 people in the class to run, and obviously not everybody who is a CTIA is actually also going into the CTEA. We are considering at the moment maybe to run regional courses for CTEA to make it a little bit easier for people to attend as well. I get another, okay, Mark presents. Yeah, okay, let me see if there are more questions coming in. The other thing that you could have a look at, there is in the download, there is a document that talks about the uptime to TA942 program. So you can download the PDF and basically get a little bit more details. Again, if you would like to have more details about the program, if you would like to get some non-obligatory, obviously, quotation for your data center, then feel free to drop us a note, and we will be able to give you a quote that you can review, and of course, then it's up to your business decision to move forward or just take it as is. Another question came in. The last TA 942 standard, I saw the data center infra rating annex F is in format 18. This is even a disclaimer that's not part of the TAA. It is still the case. Very good question. This is one of the confusions very often in the market, where and I must say it is confusing the way it's written in the document, because it is claimed as informative, but if you look at the beginning of the standard, it is clearly indicated that the document is intended to give designers for data centers input to develop telecoms infrastructure, including all the other elements of a data center. And in fairness, let's be honest, there is no point building a data center based on TA-942 and just complying to the usage of the telecoms infrastructure, because there is no point, right? How can I call myself a rated 4 data center based on TAA by only running redundancy on network cabling, for example? That makes absolutely no sense. So what you always see in the market is that everybody basically reads the document from the front to the back and apply all of the criteria that is listed. So if somebody says I'm a rated 4 based on TAA and they have no redundant power, then obviously that doesn't make any sense at all. Yeah, so yes, it is a part of the TAA certification scheme. I have another question. Hold on, I did the wrong one. This is unanswered. Let me see. Okay, mark as answered. How complex, costly to upgrade uptime tier certification to the actually is not that complex. To be honest, since the data center is already certified for TAA, for uptime, by right the electrical and mechanical systems should be in good shape. Now, one thing that I need to mention here, obviously, if you have a design certificate from uptime and you would like to move to a constructed facility certification from the TAA, then you need to be, we need to be as auditors very careful, because as I indicated, unfortunately, there are quite a few people that have designed something very different than what they have actually implemented. So then we need to go through the full rigor again and review every single detail. If it's a constructed facility, then of course we would have more confidence in that by right electrical and mechanical systems should be in good shape, although we still, of course, check our effects. But typically, to give you an idea, a typical data center, 10,000 to 20,000 square feet, 1,000 to 2,000 square meter, we would typically spend about 2 to 4 days on site. That is roughly what it is, depending on the rating levels. So it is not very complex. As long as your electrical mechanical is in good shape, do not worry too much about things like the architectural aspects. I think a lot of people are made scared by other organizations to say, oh, be careful, architecture is very difficult to achieve, your building is not purposely built, your car park is inside, etc. Don't worry too much about that one. Those are typically non-issues. They are what we call in ISO a Cat 2, not a Cat 1. Okay, so costly, very cost-effective. To give you an idea, and again, it's just roughly, it depends on scope, it depends on size, but most of the audits in this space, they tend to run from anywhere $10,000 to $30,000, roughly. That is, it's not much more than that. Okay, that is answered. Another good question: does NCTA has operation certificates for the data center like Uptime has? TAA doesn't have, but we have. Look at our website and look for the DCOS, the Data Center Operations Standard. This is the first complete data center operation standard covering everything from governance, operations, all the way down to maintenance. Far more complete than the MNO, so I would urge you to have a read at that one. If you would like to have more information on that one, please feel free to send a mail at sales@epi-ap.com and we can provide you more information. So yes, we do have certification for operations as well. Let me see, does NCTA, okay, that one is answered. Very good, okay, thank you notes, well, appreciate your time, happy to hear that you liked the presentation. Another thing, let me have a look here, is the TA-942 external audit course dedication beside the course at any, no, the only certification for external audits for TA-942 is the EPI course. So the agreement with EPI and TAA, we decided to develop this certified design consultant internal and external audit to make sure there is a quality framework for people to actually execute the audit. So be very careful. If you would like to know who is certified, you can go to the website again, TAA942.org, and there is a section, find auditing companies and find consultants and auditors. So do go to that part of the website, and there you can find the information. Again, if you want more information, feel free, of course, to drop us a note. Let's check, what kind of tests are performed by TA9 certification consultant? Are they similar to the uptime tests? Okay, very good question again. There are two scenarios. When a data center is already in operations, then obviously no data center operator would fancy to say, let's flip a breaker of the input power and hope that everything works. So normally when a site is already operational, data center operator owners do not fancy flipping breakers, pulling a cable out and hope that everything works or closing a valve. So normally the audit is then non-intrusive. So we will look at the design, we look at the physical implementation, including quality of workmanship, and we will also review all the commissioning documents. So if we, for example, see that you are, let's say that you are a rated 4 data center, and you have not done a proper failover test, blackboard building test, etc., during test and commissioning, then obviously that would be a big issue for us because we would like to see that you have done proper testing. Let's see, more questions coming in. There's all answered. Okay. It seems that we have no more questions coming in. Very good. Let me see. I'll hang on there for a couple more minutes to see if we have another 3 minutes before we close. So if you have another question, feel free to post your question. And again, do not worry. If you would like to ask a question offline, feel free to drop a note at the email addresses given, sales@epi-ap.com or sales@epi-certification.com. And we will make an effort, of course, to answer your question normally within 24 hours. Okay, well, I don't see more questions coming in. I see feedback, 5 stars, fantastic. Thank you very, very much. Appreciate the positive feedback. I hope it is very useful. Again, by all means, if you have more questions, let us know. And with that, I would like to say thank you very, very much for attending this webinar. I hope to hear from you what you think about this program. If you would like to have some more information or obviously quotation, then please feel free to contact us and we will be glad to serve you. With that, I would say thank you very much. Have a good day, good evening, good night, wherever you are, and I hope to speak to you all very soon again. Goodbye and thank you.